They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, that's I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, best up the item you choose.
Many times in the culture, hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Falling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something, the middle gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I know the solution, maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music, just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a fuck about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire.
I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me rope? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me rope? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating round here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I whipped the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, don't fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay,
since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Aye. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Aye. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe with a cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my crew, yeah. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay,
We are just across the Allegheny River from downtown Pittsburgh at rain-soaked Heinz Field in the Steel City. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Baltimore Ravens and the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Chris Boswell, the kickoff for Pittsburgh.
The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. Taken about 7 yards deep, and this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. Carry for the former Buckeye, J.K. Dobbins. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown.
Touchdown, Baltimore.
J.K. Dobbins with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Ravens have taken the early lead.
Tyler Bass set to kick off.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
At the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now 3rd down coming up.
3rd and 9.
Out of the gun, Trubisky. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. So a good punt there, but a very strong 14-yard return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. The drive will commence with a run by J.K. Dobbins. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Now that's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set him back for 2nd down.
Crouch!
Jackson on the give to Dobbins. An 8-yard gain, so that gets him halfway there. Now they're left with a third and eight more. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
The Steelers now in the nickel here on third down. Jackson from the shotgun. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Jackson to Andrews on that one. First down, Baltimore. Off the play fake to Dobbins. Here's Jackson. Across the formation, he's got a man. That's Allen. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Keenan Allen, his first touchdown on the year. And the Ravens will extend their lead. Here's Bass now for the extra point. And we'll see if this rain affects the team's decisions going forward, but they kick it here, and it's good.
Ravens 13, Steelers nothing.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
Their own 23-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. From the gun, it's Trubisky. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 3rd down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field. That looks like it's going to be 2 empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over-game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on 4th down, and they're going to go for it. Here we go on 4th down with Trubisky. And he comes back with 1 complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a 1st down. Again, it's Trubisky. And that is incomplete. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And once again, not much running room, if any at all. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd down. Those are the plays this defense needs with the deficit they're facing.
It certainly is, and they've got to continue to swarm the football and hope that someone, while they're holding up the ball carrier, can get in there and rake it and lock it free. They need to get some takeaways as well.
Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on 3rd down. Thought they were going to force a 4th down. Instead, P.I. gives them the 1st.
And that's frustrating because you think you've taken them really deep into the count, haven't you? Instead, you've got to start all over. That can really, really be demoralizing.
Kill, 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 kill.
right back to him on first down. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. But you're down early. How do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach.
And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. A 14-yard touchdown. And the Steelers are able to make this a close game again.
The big fellow was the recipient there for that touchdown pass, and it seems like more and more the tight end is the guy you have to worry about most in the passing game.
And this one through the uprights and good.
Steelers 7. Chris Boswell to kick off for Pittsburgh.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Taken about 7 yards deep. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
22-yard line.
Raven offense set at the line for this next drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. To throw again, Jackson. And that'll be incomplete. J.K. Dobbins, the one he was looking for. And it's third down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
On third down, Jackson. And that will be incomplete.
I like what they tried to do there. Tried to hit him with something quick, get the ball in his hands, and hope he can make some yards after the catch and pick up a first down. Weren't able to do so on that play.
The Ravens send their punter out now as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10.
At their own 40-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. And I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
Flush to his right. Goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
They'll come up after the sack on a second and 12. Here to his running back. And some room to maneuver. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 23 yards the pick up there.
At the 40-yard line.
An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports.
13. Steelers 7.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look.
I got you. Shit.
throwing here, Trubisky. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line.
They'll take over first.
And Brandon, the passing game for both of these teams is going to be affected as the game goes along. It's not looking like the rain's going to let up anytime soon. So that might mean a few more wobbly passes and wide receiver slips. And this one winds up getting intercepted.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. From the gun, Jackson. That'll be complete to Dobbins.
Jackson.
A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
A gain of a yard. Brings up second.
From the gun, it's Jackson.
At the Steelers.
He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. Stephon Tuitt able to shake free and get home for the sack.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Jackson on third and long. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. The Steeler defense locked in, forcing an upcoming fourth down. They're going for a receiver there. Already has one touchdown in this first half, a second one not to be.
I like where their headspace is, though. I mean, I really like the thought process, right? You got a guy who's already scored one, right? You want to go back to him, continue the hot hand, and make them adjust to you defensively. I like what they were trying to get done, even though they weren't successful. I tell you, it's not easy kicking field goals in the best of conditions. Yet in a downpour like we're in right now, it makes it that much harder. And sure enough, they can't convert here.
He's crossing. He's checking crack. Mike 56, Mike. Warn.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense going to have to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. From the shotgun is Trubisky. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up third and
on third down, Trubisky. And he can't quite corral it defensively. Maybe some space to go the other direction if he had caught it. That brings up fourth down now.
Fourth down.
The Steelers send out their punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time. That's taken on the 25. A pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they have to feel like they missed on an opportunity for points last time when they couldn't connect on that short field goal try.
And no doubt about it, because they were counting on those points. In today's NFL, let's face it, that's really a chip shot, right?
That's anything. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he may want to to track down that football because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Looking to throw on second down. Trubisky. And his throw here is incomplete. Johnson the intended target, but now it's third down.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Now Trubisky to throw. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. DeForest Buckner with a sack, the former number 7 overall pick. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And right around the 20, he'll head out of bounds. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
First down.
From the gun, Jackson. Going deep here for Allen. And it's intercepted. The safety, Terrell Edmonds, picks it. They had him back deep, got the interception, and now they start inside the 10.
Partner, forget starting inside the red zone. They're inside the green zone. From the 10-yard line in, a lot of teams call it that because that's the money zone. Get it into the end zone and make your cash.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. And again, this time to the tailback. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a gain of a yard, and it takes us to the 2-minute warning.
It's a gain of a yard.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
That's complete, right around the 8. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. No yardage to speak of whatsoever. Leads to a third down.
Third and goal.
Trubisky, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Read it well, and it's picked. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They are in an interception mood on defense. Had two nice interceptions a week ago. Now two here in the first half.
Yeah, we call it ball hawking. And the only way to truly be good ball hawks is not guessing. It's not just simply anticipation. It's study and understanding what they like to do and beating them to the spot and creating big plays.
They're watching the film, and it's working. After the interception, here's Jackson. He'll find Dobbins out of the backfield.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard.
Operating from the gun.
Jackson.
And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Here's Jackson on third down. The catch made by Miller. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. On first and 10, it's Jackson. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. 11 more on that one and another first down.
But he's certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Picked off by Cameron Sutton.
Certainly feels like the classic second guess, but let's be honest about it. They had a chance going to halftime with the lead. Why did they take a chance with a throw there? I don't understand that.
Well, that's what I'm wondering, and now this defense has to try to protect that lead going into the locker room. After the interception, here's Trubisky. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Tavon Young. And the return will stop them well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line. So that is 3 interceptions now in this first half. And you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back?
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by Cameron Sutton.
Intercepted. The Steelers take over.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll...
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off around the 41. And a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, looking for Andrews downfield. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort, but it's well short. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Ravens out in front. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Tyler Bass set to kick off.
Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Second and six, just inside the 30. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And it works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Third down, it's Trubisky. Open man is Sims. He's got it. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
45-yard line.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Right at the line of
scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Second and 10.
False start's going to push him back, but these days, how hard must it be to be an offensive lineman?
It's very hard, Brandon. You've got defensive linemen flinching, trying to draw you offside. You've got the loud crowds, and there are just so many super athletic players on defense now that you have to deal with each week. But through it all, these guys just sit in there for four quarters and slug it out.
Push him back.
Now Trubisky to throw on second. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Now Trubisky on third and long. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 21. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in. Coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
A gain of 12. And the Raven first down.
Here's Jackson. Now he's flushed out left. Over the middle, complete. It's Andrews. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That one goes for 24 yards. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw is Jackson. Flushed out right. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. And he'll get this pretty close to a first down as he's tackled at the Steelers 23. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Brings up third down.
see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. They're able to convert with a gain of four.
A gain of 4 yards. First down, Baltimore.
From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown.
Touchdown.
Hollywood, Marquise Brown. His sixth touchdown of the season as the Ravens push further out in front. John Harbaugh thought about it, and now his guys are going to go for the two-point conversion. And they'll try to run it in with Dobbins. They'll try and run it here. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more.
Steelers 7.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
Now a pass that's taken in by Smith-Schuster. And now off to the races, down the right side. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Juju Smith-Schuster, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers have now made this a one-score game. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now.
Ravens 21. Steelers 14.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And with a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call. That holding call set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
And the holding penalty sets him back inside the 20 as they get going on this drive. Now Jackson on first down. It's complete to Brown, right side. There he goes, right side. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Marquise Brown, 84 yards. And the Ravens will add on to their lead.
Well, that is certainly a deflator right there defensively. Their guys just came off of a touchdown drive. They're back in the game, and then bam. They give up a touchdown one play later. How about that?
And the momentum, which seemingly had shifted the other direction, thought we might be seeing a comeback. That momentum right back the other way.
Well, that is certainly not complimentary football that we saw right there. The defense is supposed to help their offense, not give up another touchdown.
No, I can't go. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? We'll see what they decide to do.
A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Back now in Pittsburgh. Steelers. It's the Steelers with the football, but trailing here as we get going in quarter number four. Here's a second and two now from the 33. Now it's Trubisky. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 4 yards the pickup. First down. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical. And you figure they only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
First down, Trubisky. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
Now, that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back on maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
To throw again on second down. Trubisky. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. DeForest Buckner picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Well, you don't usually get a sack from a nose tackle spot, but we got one there.
No, we don't. And a lot of the times in passing situations, they end up off the field anyway. So how happy was he to work his way back to the quarterback and put him on the ground? He's going to end up with a nickname after something like that, some big jelly or something like that.
The gun, it's Trubisky. He'll air this one out deep for Sims. And unable to connect, incomplete. Give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They'll try and throw for it with Trubisky. He's going to go up top again. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 25. And he'll bring it all the way back just a yard or two shy of midfield. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
That catch good for only a couple.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Now this throw caught left side, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Mike 57. Watch the run.
From the gun, Jackson. Eluding the pressure right. His throw caught at about the five. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Scotty Miller, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Ravens turn that interception into a touchdown. Footing always a concern, but the extra points up and good. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. This will be fielded inside the five. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
At their own 27-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Remember, they have won three straight, but getting to four straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. Flush to his right. Going right, and that's complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. Give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
The tackle made at the 44-yard line.
Out of the gun, Trubisky. Open man here, Sims complete. And they're going to have this in a great spot way down in Baltimore territory. It's a big play there for the Steelers. And even 50 yards.
First and goal at the 6.
Now whistles here before the snap, and it looks like one of the Steelers may have moved. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up third down. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll find his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
Brings up second and goal.
Second down and goal. Trubisky escaping the pressure. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Mitchell Trubisky, his third touchdown of the game, number 14 on the year. And the Steelers are able to cut into that deficit. And he puts it through.
Good. Makes the score Ravens 35, Steelers 21.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Taken in the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
20-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. This game was really a tussle, seemed like just a moment ago, and now they've got the momentum. A couple of scores on their last pair of drives and a 2-score lead. I think here now you go conservative, right? Run the football, work the clock.
You know, I usually agree with you, but I'm going after them right here.
Really?
I want to put this bad boy away. I wouldn't be afraid to throw it. They've got all the confidence, all the momentum on their side. Go ahead and take your dagger shots and try and finish this one off.
I disagree vehemently. I say run the football. You've got the lead.
Well, let's watch it and find out who's right.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A gain of 13, it's a first down. I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Jackson's going to throw it. And he's going to find a man, Keenan Allen. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That goes for a gain of 31.
Touchdown.
The first down carry here for Johnson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead.
Gain of 14. First down, Ravens.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And now he's going to use his legs. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
7 brings up 2nd and 3.
Now Dobbins. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up 1st and goal.
Again, idea. Let's skip racing to the airport at the end of this game. Let's go to the post-game press conference. I have a feeling that the quarterback of this winning team is going to be giving a whole lot of credit to the running game and the offensive line.
Yeah, I was just going to say the offensive line. Yes, carrying the ball has been key, but those guys up front, they've made a lot of space.
That's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
2nd and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Jackson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. From the gun, it's Jackson. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And he is going to be stopped on the return at his own 3-yard line. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his 2nd interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me, because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go. And he's going to lose yardage back to his own 1-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's 2nd down. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So for the Ravens, the win will help them keep pace in the playoff race as they move to 6-3 on the year. And they will head home next week to take on the L.A. Chargers. Meanwhile, for Pittsburgh, their season is on life support somewhat now at 3-6. And they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to KC to take on the Chiefs. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.